First though, in just 5 years, Perth's Fringe Festival has grown rapidly to become the third biggest in the world. Running alongside the more traditional Perth International Arts Festival, Fringe World has proved a hit with audiences by showcasing affordable and often experimental shows. But with more than 700 acts on offer this year, and some artists struggling, has the Fringe become too big? Catherine Diss has been finding out.
Hello, Dove. Do you want to be famous? I'm famous Sharon. Lovely to meet you.
Self-proclaimed famous Sharon is very, very famous for absolutely nothing at all.
Can you do duck face? You go, perfect, Al. Okay, ready? Here we go.
The Perth performer launched into stand-up comedy when Fringe debuted in Perth 5 years ago.
Walk, walk, walk and turn rock star! And then I just do magical costume change. Amazing!
She's one of thousands of performers taking part in the annual month-long festival, which attracts artists from interstate and overseas.
We've got a tasting plate of the best right on our doorstep. Dels, you used to have to fly to Edinburgh to see some of these shows, and now you can just catch a bus from Balga.
Fringe World has become a huge success. It had just 20 shows when it launched in Perth's cultural precinct in 2011. This year it has more than 700 acts across 150 venues and is expected to draw crowds of more than 750,000 people. And it's also expected to exceed last year's box office sales of $6.4 million. It's now the third largest fringe in the world, behind the festival's pioneer Edinburgh and Adelaide in South Australia. The key to its success, offering cheap and fun entertainment.
I'm here with my family. We're having a picnic with Red Jam.
Red Jam.
This is the feminist musical anthem.
With all the girls.
Frisky and Manish were a headline act at Perth's first Fringe.
What about girls just wanna have fun?
Nope, girls would like a career, please.
Man, I feel like a woman.
Man, I feel like a woman. Man being central to all things.
Oh my God, are you on your period? Please calm down.
The London-based duo have attended their fair share of Edinburgh Fringe festivals and say the cheap and cheerful style of entertainment has appealed to Perth audiences.
We are a kind of a cheap night out,
yeah.
And that's what it is about. You know, each show's fast and it's not cheap in hopeful presentation.
or in morals.
That it is.
Okay.
But it's at an accessible ticket price.
Sister Suffragette.
Beyonce, the position has been filled.
That's been such a focus for us, is really trying to attract a lot of people that never really saw themselves going to an arts festival in the past.
My name is Muscle Crowe.
The festival started as the experimental offshoot of the more established Perth International Arts Festival, which has just launched its 64th annual festival. The two overlap for 10 days, which has caused friction in the past due to limited space and venues in the city.
I think at first PF was like, what's this? What's happening over here? We're the big festival in Perth. Because Perth has never had such a successful fringe festival. So everyone was a bit taken aback. And now they're like, oh, you're our fabulous little dancing cousin.
The model is similar to the Edinburgh Fringe, which started in 1947 when a small group of performers turned up to the local international arts festival uninvited. They performed on the fringes of the main event, aiming to prove anyone should be allowed to take part. More artists joined the movement each year, and to this day, the two festivals still run side by side. Marcus Canning says that's evidence the two festivals can work together.
It's the healthy tension of any kind of slightly competitive environment. You know? It brings the best out in people. It grows market, it doesn't diminish market.
From my point of view, these these two festivals, you know, the Fringe and the International Arts Festival, sit beautifully side by side. I don't see them as our competitors, I see them as our partners.
Unlike Fringe, which is open to anyone, PIAF is a curated event, which means all shows on offer are chosen by the board's artistic director, Wendy Martin, and her team. The performances tend to be vastly different from those at Fringe and are on average more costly.
But with the rapid growth of Fringe shows on offer and its spread into outlying suburbs such as Mandurah and Fremantle, has Perth's Fringe become too big?
It really has grown to the point where we really have to chase down the audience that we think would enjoy our show, whereas, yeah, we had a lovely ride to begin with.
It's totes more competitive, but that's good, isn't it, Daz? We've just got to get a bit more match fit.
This is a really key question we keep asking is, like, when is it too big and when do we need to start putting some things in place to slow down growth? We still feel that the festival is at a really vibrant stage of its growth and that the average audiences right across the festival have been really strong.
For famous Sharon, as the Fringe grows, so does her profile.
How different is Shaz to Bonnie?
Well, it's funny because you're talking about my manager, who looks a lot like me. Does she's very plain, nondescript. She's all about the emails. Nothing she ever did was very successful. And then she started managing me, and everything's exploded. I'm her hit song.
Oh, I need to do